Intestinal failure is an inability or compromise in our GI tract's ability to perform its function. For instance, if there is a reduction in the length of our intestines, or if there's inflammation or inability to absorb and maintain the adequate amounts of proteins, electrolytes, fluids, and calories, certain complications associated with poor nutritional intake or inadequate nutrition includes compromise in the immune system, inability to grow, muscle wasting and atrophy, inability to maintain really the function of the organs throughout the body. The body's functions can start to cannibalize itself, and that's why we see people who are starting to use up their own internal stores to the point where they are unable to maintain just regular bodily functions. Sometimes intestinal failure is diagnosed by the knowledge beforehand that there is a shortened length of small bowel, or after one has actually undergone multiple surgeries, or severe inflammatory disease. There are several outcomes for a patient with short bowel syndrome or intestinal failure. For the lucky ones, they have adapted to the shortened bowel and had compensatory growth and increased absorption. You also have patients who have intestinal failure and require supplementation with IV nutrition. One of the fortunate developments is that there is ongoing research as well as recent developments in the care of these patients. Even in our own anecdotal experience, we've been able to either reduce the amount of time that somebody would need IV nutrition, or even sometimes wean them completely off IV nutrition. There are also surgical techniques that can be utilized for this disease. For instance, we do have experience with bowel lengthening procedures, using your same segment of small intestine, and by cutting it in a zigzag fashion, you can create an elongated segment of bowel. And then there's also the option of small bowel transplant from a donor. There is very emergent research on the potential use of stem cells and the development of artificial organs created on a scaffolding with stem cells. In the presence of a shortened bowel, there are certain foods that become a little bit less tolerant than if you were to have a normal length bowel. So we may include a dietitian and nutritional therapies. There really isn't a magic bullet to really address the problem. It's actually a complex interplay of the different nutritional, pharmacologic, and also lifestyle changes and strategies that actually together provides improvement in the quality of life. And that is why a multidisciplinary care of the patient is actually very important to provide the best quality care in this very complex disease.